December 1930. Stray Dog and the Lying Princess. If only there was something in this room she could sleep on instead of the floor. She's missing her brooch. Jennifer found Stray Dog. Stray Dog and the Lying Princess. Once upon a time, there was a little girl who told lies. She liked to scare the other girls by screaming, "Stray dog is coming! Stray dog is coming!" But soon, everyone stopped being scared. They hated the way that she lied. One day, the girl came home screaming, "Stray dog is coming! Really!" Everyone thought it was just another lie. Except this time, it was no lie at all, and so they were all gobbled up. The end. The stories are all inspired by grim fairy tales, and usually specific ones, but that one's pretty obvious, at least for me, because The Boy Who Cried Wolf was a story that my mom constantly referenced when I was a kid. She still says it. when I exaggerate things, she's like, "Oh, you're being the boy who cried wolf." Actually, I don't think The Boy Who Cried Wolf was even a grim fairy tale. I could be wrong, though. They need to know not to mess with me after that shit. To be fair, I am holding a gun, so. Is every room locked here? A sooty portrait is on the wall. This chapter is very short. Confined to the shadows, the plant seems to desperately crave sunlight. Okay, the thunder is a little much. You'd think you could calm down, Thunder? Like, the thunderstorm must be right over the mansion for it to keep thundering, like, every 2 seconds. A brand new ladder. Gardening tools are neatly arranged. They seem well maintained. There's an adult's bicycle. There are many empty cases. Names are written on the tags. Meg, Diana, Nicholas. Like I said before, this chapter is very short, so I feel justified in wandering around a bit. I don't think we can use this until the epilogue anyway. It's strange that they keep a projector in, like, a damp, moldy room like this. As if it wouldn't be, like, a luxury in this day and age, especially for, like, an orphanage that clearly lacks funding. Upstairs. Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Back to the main hallway. There's nowhere else we can go here. Every room is locked. She has her socks back. And this one's still locked, right? Aww.
Greetings. Princess, please forgive all that I've done.
Greetings, Princess Jennifer. Thank you very much for coming to our new aristocrat club.
Greetings, Princess Jennifer. From now on, you'll be our new princess.
Now, Princess, please think up a new game.
Please lead us. We are yours to command, Princess.
Princess, go ahead! Guide us! We need you! We don't know what to do!
Look! Look, it's Wendy. It's Wendy.
What?
Stray Dog legend. That is just Wendy's lie. I'm in no hurry.
Once upon a time, there was a precious little girl.
This is the final boss. There's really no advice I can give besides just like try to get behind him, and it might be best to like run away after you do a few swipes because he's gonna do that attack where he does that and knock you over. But you don't really have to worry about worrying. Don't really have to worry about doing. He's always with her. Like, why not give him the rest of the food? Because you wouldn't love me. Because you were so stubborn. I brought you here. Because you fell in love with Brown. Because you didn't realize it was me. I brought Stray Dog here. But I... Please stop him with this. Only you and your beloved dog can stop him. I'm sorry. Jennifer found Gregory's gun. Gregory's gun. Oh, do you want to see the bad ending? This is the bad ending. And you can also get this ending by just killing him however you want. Wait, yeah, just kill him.
I'm sorry, Joshua.
And that is how the girl wound up all alone again. She couldn't keep her promise, nor did she save anyone. What a pitiful, unlucky girl. And the good ending? Oh, and the game just ends right there with the credits.
I'm sorry, Joshua.
I'm sorry, Joshua.